What's up guys, Sal here. So the Galaxy S10 has a cutout for the front-facing camera, which Samsung calls Infinity O Display, a version of punch hole camera technology, which places a front-facing module in a corner of the display as a result of precision laser cutting. Samsung says that the technology used to drill the hole on the Galaxy S10 was very challenging, as well as a noteworthy achievement. But what comes next is perhaps the most challenging task for Samsung or for any company out there. A full-screen smartphone with no holes, no bezels, no notches, and no more dry setups. Just a seamless full-screen smartphone. To achieve that, Samsung needs to put the camera out of sight under the display without impacting its functionality and performance. Last year, Samsung showcased to some investors that they have the technology, but having the tech doesn't mean it's ready for full-time production. And that's what Samsung's vice president of mobile R&D group display said in an interview. He said, and I quote, "Though it wouldn't be possible to make a full-screen smartphone in the next 1 to 2 years, the technology can move forward to the point where the camera hole will be invisible while not affecting the camera's function in any way." So what he's basically saying is, don't expect the Galaxy S11 to have this new tech, which shouldn't be a surprise to anyone as Samsung changes their design once in 2 years. The Galaxy S11 will see a minor design tweak, nothing major except some features on the inside. There are more chances that the Galaxy S12 could have it though. The Galaxy S12 will surely see a design change, and the 1 to 2 years that he's mentioning falls perfectly in line with the launch of the Galaxy S12. So 2021 is the year I guess we'll see our first ever full screen smartphone with zero compromises. By the way, the VP of Samsung Display also said that Samsung is working on crystal sound OLED display, which can make the screen double as a speaker. With this technology, there's no need for a speaker at the top, which helps in eliminating that small bezel at the top that is currently required for the earpiece. We've seen Samsung showcasing this technology last year at Display Week, and the Galaxy S10 was initially expected to have the technology. But for some reason, they didn't go with that. But there's a huge possibility that the Galaxy Note 10 could have this. LG showed with the G8 that this sound on display tech is ready for prime time. Also, this tech will surely give the Galaxy Note 10 a great differentiating factor. So I think it's about time Samsung should also consider adding this to their flagships, as it's not only functional, but also helps in increasing the screen to body ratio even more. Consider subscribing for daily updates like this. And as always, I'll see y'all tomorrow. Peace out.